Awesome. Leash bottle M. Okay, that's the medium potion for restoring magic points. The funny thing is, I wish we found more money in these things. That's what we really need. A cat's eye? Chest is empty. Did I check the front of this one? So a cat's eye is something to sell to dealers, right? It's a gem. One of many gemstones you can sell to shops has a streak of light like a cat's eye. Okay, I'll have to remember to sell that. Oh, we got a pierced spear? That's the thing we were gonna not buy, maybe, for Ada. Well, she gets to definitely have it now. Sweet, now we get to sell her blue dragon spear. So, in essence, we did find money here. So her attack goes up by 10 and defense by 1, which is what this new set of stuff is giving us, set of equipment. I like the song, I like the music. Alright, so that's what's over here. Can't get past that. Came from here, right? So this is the area with the pillar, maybe. Oh, we need some healings. Kind of alternating between Una and Jan, the dog. A little bit more. I'm like, what the hell was that? It's just one of these things. There's that pillar. If we didn't need the money, guys, I'd be, like, ignoring all these. McBain's gonna need some more magic points. We use that leash bottle M, maybe. We have a lot more of them, too. And we have a large leash bottle L. We got a full meters. These monsters are too easy, though, especially when we surprise them like that. I think the noise bell is overpowered. Because that's what's making them, like, not want to fight us, and half the time we get surprise attacks because they're trying to run away from us. Okay. Now we kill this thing. Boop. Another door there, too. We'll do that so all the physical attacking people can reach, because McBain's doesn't need to. We're gonna kill you. extinguish you forever. Nope. I'm gonna use these special attacks. $420, I love it. Ada? Yeah! It looks like she barely made it too. To level 27. Got a little bit more, a little bit extra. Rock crash, yes. Do it! Do it now! Pew! Pew! Ooh! Rock pillar key. We can use it again? I did not know we could use that again. Orb of Ocean 98. And 101. And then more. 98 and 101. Keep doing it. I haven't been looking at them, I've just been reading off what they are. 98 is image of Argus shouting. 101 is image of Kachua shouting. So we've got shouting going on in here. What else is in here? I mean, we're supposed to be going back downstairs, but what's in here? Oh, we got this huge thing. The hell is that? Oh, wow. Stairs down there. Huh. Sure. Rock crash, yes. Pew! Pew! Ah, more chests, nice. A flame sword? What? We found a flame sword. And an emerald. I know that's to sell to vendors. I don't think the flame sword is going to be very helpful against these things, though. Maybe we'll equip that afterwards. Hold on. Brings his attack up by 4, but only Forte can use for whatever reason. Sword with a blazing blade and inflicts fire damage on the victim. Okay, so I'm not gonna equip that yet. Not in this dungeon where things are made out of fire. Stand by, guys. I'll be right back. Okay. We have some stuff to fight. How much money these things give. Boop! Maybe if I had approached them really from the behind, we'd be surprised. Okay, they're golems. Now, depending on the game you're playing, golems only take magic damage or golems only take physical damage. I don't know which one this is. I'll have, I mean, the flame sword might be good against the golems, but I can't equip it now. So I'll have Forte hit Golem A and see what happens. You'll attack Hellhound. You'll do Ice Rain. And you'll attack Hellhound. I'm gonna interrupt the golem. Let's see if he does any damage. 115, okay. Woof! Interrupting golem A. Oh, it should get both of them. Nice. Not too bad. I don't do a lot of damage with the ice rain to the golems. So if we're gonna get more of these battles, we're gonna need magic. So, first we'll use magic. And then we'll regain magic. Who really is low on magic? Una should be doing the healing right now. I think. Okay, good. And now potions. Leash bottle M. Now I'm gonna use this. I could use a bunch of small ones, but I'm gonna use M because once you get to 10, that's the end of your stack. This one we found like a while ago. I was like surprised. But we'll use M just to ensure that we can collect some more M, right? And I'll use some small ones. Okay. That should be good enough. Alright, so we got that thing. Stairs. Get back here, you scaredy cat. Surprise the enemy. Oh, it's really just one golem. Alright. Surprised. McBain won't be able to reach. Yeah, that was tiny. Tiny. Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay. We need your fat loot. Now he has more magic points for more ice rain. Hooray for ice rain. That one. Let's save it. I was thinking about it, but nah. This thing's got one hit left. Say anywhere how many roses. Yeah. Okay, so we've got almost. Yeah, we've. Five. We've got like a little over 6,000, I guess. It's pretty good. ice rain. Does a body good. Doomed, buddy. That won't save you. He's just gonna walk over and stand there. Brad, level 28, nice. There was this tunnel here, or something, doorway. Alright, looks like we killed everything in the vicinity, so let's go through that door. Or stairs, rather. Where are we now? Ah, chest. A lot of chests, I like it. Oh, cure bottle L. Okay, so that's a large healing of the hit points. Yes. I wonder how many of them we have. We have two now of those. I remember, I don't think it was this game, I think it was a Tear of a Million. We would, like, never use this stuff, so I'd start using up the small because we had 10 of them, rather than use medium or large, and sometimes even when I didn't need it, I'm like, okay, we have 10 bottle S's, I found another potion in this chest, so instead of using our magic to heal ourselves, let's use cure bottle S and then pick up one, and then we still had 10. In the end. I like that. Kinda had to be there. Oh, there's only one? I am disappointed. Just one of you alone is not gonna have enough fat loots. And McBain doesn't get to go. Una can shoot. Alright, so there was a chest there. Oh, that's only... Wait. Oh, we have another way to go up this way. Golem. Alright, we need to head north after we kill this. There's a bunch. We're gonna use our special attacks this time. Hellhound B. Ice rain. Now, oh, two hits, we kill it. Ice rain, and the rest of us will attack Golem A. And interrupt Hellhound A. Now we're gonna kill this thing. Charge dog. I'll save McBean. The next time. Oh. Not an effective spell this time. Only one. Forgot all about it. Not that I could stop him from casting it anyway. It's too late. That should be a lot of money. Yeah, 120. So in essence, 600 gents we just made off of that. Alright, we're going north. Oh, we're back here. Oh, this is a new area. It looked like the same area. Let's kill this. Blood leech. Oh, we got a bunch. We surprised the enemy, right? I think it said. Oh, we need a little bit of healings. Blood leech B. Let's do the all heal. Why not? I don't think I've seen that happen yet. Have I? Oh, wait. For him, we need the ice rain. Yeah. It doesn't hurt the others as much as the hellhound thing, but it still damages them a good amount, I think. I should finish off the Hellhound. And we'll attack the Blood Leech A. I'll do Ice Rain again. Interrupt the Hellhound. You may not go! Sweet! That was awesome. Jan always goes first. It's a swift doggy. So Jan will heal Forte. Can't attack. Alame gets to go. Owie. Wow. Huh. Look at Forte. Oh, look at McBain. Forte's got 5 points next level. McBain has one. Una has one. And Jan and Rick have seven. And I said eight is trying to catch up, but Fred's ahead of us. How'd that happen? Healings. Okay, so... One more leash bottle M on McBeam. Save. Like, I have a feeling we're heading some boss battle, that's why I keep saving. Underground ruins. Oh, we weren't in the ruins yet? Now we're in the ruins? The old bait and switch, huh? Well, the music certainly sounds very somber. Uh-huh. Ah, says Forte. Yeah, what is that? Oh, tiles. Fred says, this must be the real treasure. Leon Slate, too, says Una. To the righteous one, I leave the resonant stone of fire behind with the menace of the water tribe. To the one who has discovered the existence of evil, the power of the resonant stone is to be used to curb the evil power. Do not touch what's deep inside. Pray for world peace and keep it in your mind. Fred says, all in all, that chest is the resonant stone. McBain says, you said, with the menace of the water tribe? This can't be happening. What does it mean? They have menace? Towards who? Us? Una says, I can feel a stronger feeling from this slate. Let's check out the resonance stone first, says McBean. Forte and his friends obtained the resonance stone of fire. Yeah, no surprise there. That's exactly what I expected, McBean says. It has fire carved on it. It was worth enduring that heat, says Forte. Una says, this resonance stone will take care of the slate corresponding to fire in the limestone cave. Yes, correct. What is that slate about? Asked Fred. Forte explained to Fred about the six slates in a limestone cave. I see. So you'll need darkness. McBain says, but before that, we need to take care of the menace written on Leon's slate. It must be in the back room. In the back room. It sounds very forbidding, foreboding, and all that. So, see, if the chest is the stone, just take it. We don't have to deal with the menace of the water tribe. The power of the resonant stone is to be used to curb the evil power. So fire, then. Do not touch what's deep inside. Pray for world peace. Keep it in your mind. Alright, so let's equip this then. Mind's Eye, I think. I think this is to uncover invisible creatures, maybe? Let's give fire for that. Oh, I didn't look at fire. Right, let's just go over the ones we have. Right, these are all equipped, or most of them, except for Earth. Purification is resonant stone found in the underground waterway in Krenka. Cures negative effects. That's a good thing. I've used it once or twice recently. Resonant stone, yeah, found in the cave between Trim and Viento reveals invisible monsters. That's Mind's Eye. We haven't come across any invisible monsters lately, so I figure that's a good one to replace. Water, resonant stone found in the Aqua Harp cave, casts a water attack spell. Life is resonant stone received from Grandpa Raisin, casts healing spells. Una's been using that one. Earth is a resonant stone found in the basement of the quarry, casts an earth attack spell. Lullaby, resonant stone previously owned by the Swing Gang, makes enemies fall asleep. Hasn't been working on monsters lately. Well, we tried it on some extremely powerful enemies, so that's probably why. Perseverance, resonant stone received from Viscount Eagle in Dargarna, boasts defense power. Technique, resonant stone given by Edgar in Envolin, raises allies' attack rate. Bind is resonant stone found on Riotom Island, freezes the enemy's movement. Target, resonant stone found in a cave near a lake, increases chance of critical hits. Light is resonant stone found in the Shrine of Lightning, casts a light attack spell. March is resonant stone found in a cave between Marcha and Shulf, accelerates movement. Force is resonant stone received from Oratorio in Shulf, boosts attack power. Wind is resonant stone taken by Beregger from the Wind Cave, casts a wind attack spell. And finally, fire, resonant stone found underground in Selbart, casts a fire attack spell. Okay. So, I haven't been using Perseverance either, so let's replace that with Earth. Alright, everything else is equipped. Oh, we have Wind here. Plus defense goes down, but his attack goes up. Strange. Up by 2, but down by 1. Target. Okay, we'll replace target with wind. Let's save the game, because that's obviously a boss battle coming up. And I made all these changes. I don't want to have to do it all over again. Okay. What the hell is that? Vorte says, what's that?